Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. Now let's have a look at the while loop. While loop is used extensively in programming and also in Arduino. So what is a while loop? A while loop is a type of loop which executes block of code until a certain condition is met. And when the condition is met, the loop exits. So let's see how we can define a while loop. While loop will be defined this way. While loop starts with a word while with lowercase w, and then we have open and close parentheses here. And then the other important part of it is this curly braces, that's the opening, and then we have also the closing. And then the condition goes between these two parentheses that opens and close here. In English, it means while this condition is true, do these codes, whatever is between this opening and closing. And here is a very basic while loop example. We have a variable b of type integer and the value is 4. Now we have a while loop. This while loop says that while b is greater than 0, do this. We said whatever is between these two will be executed, so do this. So what it means is that when b is greater than 0, at the moment b is greater than 0, then it says decrement, which means subtract 1 from b, and then print the b, and when it code reaches here, it goes back. So this is what happens. First, it compares b, then it comes to this section. First, we will decrement, b becomes 3, and then we will print it. So this line will print b for us, and after that we go back here. Now b is 3. Is 3 bigger than 0? True. If this is true, then continue. Come here and then decrement. When it decrements, b now becomes 2. Then after this line will print it for us. It will become 2. After this, it goes back here, compares. Now is true. Come back here, subtract 1 from 2, so 2 becomes 1. And then print, this line will print it, and after this we go again, and then compare. Is 1 bigger than 0? True. Come here, decrement it, it becomes 0, and then print b. Now after this, again compares. Is 0 bigger than 0? False. And this cannot happen. Nothing will be executed and the while loop exits. So the while loop stays here as long as the condition between the two parentheses are true. This will continue doing whatever is inside here. If you found this tutorial helpful, please thumb up and also click on the subscribe on the right side in the lower corner. I really appreciate it. Now let's have another example. This time we have b equals 0, and here now I put it below, so it will first print, and then this is incrementing. Plus plus mean add one more to b. First we compare. If b smaller than 4, true, because b is 0 and 4 is large. Then the code comes here, prints b, and then increments. B is 1 now. From here, code goes back here, compares. Is 1 smaller than 4? True. Comes here, prints 1, increments. B is 2, goes back here, compare. Is 2 smaller than 4? True. Prints 2, increment. B becomes 3, goes back there. Is 3 smaller than 4? True. Now we print 3, we end, B becomes 4, and when the code goes back here, compares, 4 is not smaller than 4, exit, increment, example 3. This time we check the J. We have one variable called J, initial value is true, and we have integer B, this is 0. And we have a while loop, checks the J. J is a boolean, automatically it is either true or false. Prints, increments, and here we have extra condition. Here it says if B is equal 3, this means equal, it compares it. If it is 3, then set J equal false. So if B is equal 3, we are changing J to false. Initially it is true. So first, while J, is J true? Because it is true, comes here and prints 0. And then increment, B is 0, B becomes 1. This is false, because B is not equal 3, so this condition is not true, so this will not happen. It goes here. Now, is J true? Yes, because we have not changed it. J is still true. Come here and print 1, increments it, becomes 2. 2 is not equal 3, this will not be executed. It goes here. J is true, prints 2, increments it, B become 3. Now here we check B is equal to 3, true, then we will change J is equal false. Now this comes here, J is equal false, the code will exit. Nothing will be executed as soon as this is false. This time we are using a new syntax, break, in order to break the code regardless of this condition. Let's check it. We have B equals 0 and B is smaller than 4. It's true. This will print it and B becomes 1. This is not true. It will not be executed. B, 1 is smaller than 4. Print become 2. Now is B equals 2? Yes. Break. Break means do not go there immediately. Code will exit from loop and proceeds to the code after this curly parenthesis. Another loop called loop. This is exactly the same as a loop, but the condition of while, which was at the beginning, now it's at the end, and we have the word do at the beginning. So that's why this is called do while. This is exactly the same example, the same outcome, I'm just presenting it. So initially, it doesn't compare. Initially, it just executes the code. This code execution involves first decrement, so B becomes 3, and then print, it becomes 3, and then after that compare, is B bigger than 0? True. Goes here, decrement, B becomes 2, prints 2, compare, is 2 bigger than 0? True. Decrement become 1, print 1, is 1 bigger than 0, true, and then decrement, B becomes 0, and then print 0, because after this we print it, then we come here, is 0 bigger than 0, false, immediately exit. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.